Okay, well, I guess it's time to start. So, hello everyone. It's a great pleasure for me to be here again for this new webinar. Today is going to be about applying MBSE as a support for systems engineering standard. So it will be presented by Sébastien Duby that I will introduce in just a second. So I am Laurent Delegue. I've been working at Ubeo for the last 15 years or so, and specialized on MBSE for the last years. And now, without further ado, I'm just going to introduce Sébastien. So Sébastien Dubé, let me take my notes. He is a senior systems engineers and modeling consultant at Samaris. He's a Capella and product line engineering expert, an Arcadia Capella experienced coach and trainer. And experience, we mean more than 20 years experience in embedded systems architecture and development for various industries, automotive, railway, avionics, and so on. He's also certified by ENCOSI and CSAMS. So, Sébastien, welcome. And now it's up to you. The floor is yours.
Okay, hello everyone. So now I will introduce this webinar. So this webinar is named Applying MBSE as a Support for Systems Engineering Standards. And I've added a specific note. We will present, we will walk through this methodology through a specific case study called the Health Agriculture Human Aircraft Vehicle that we will introduce later on. So just to start, so this webinar is will have the following sections. So we'll first have a first recall of systems engineering practices. So why we do that? Because we perform a lot of consulting about systems engineering on some various industry, and we notice that sometimes people struggle with difficulties to understand really how to implement the systems engineering standard practices and have an efficient approach with models, and how to apply MBSE is sometimes difficult on some topics. So we'll recall some basics, just a reminder on the systems engineering standards, and then we will go to the Arcadia classical approach method, and then we will present a kind of mapping between this Arcadia method to the systems engineering practices based on the systems engineering standard, like ISO 15288 standard, which is a well-known systems engineering standard from the community. Then we will introduce our case study that is used by Samaris as a support for training and coaching activities, and we'll see step by step this approach, how we have modeled it in using Capella and Arcadia methodology, using the what I've called the classical top-down approach for this case study. And then I will introduce just after that some specific topics. So we have performed a kind of focus on some systems engineering practices and how to map them with the Arcadia and Capella method using the specific examples. And then we will go to a short conclusion. So first of all, I will recall just the context. So on the definition, so what is an engineered system? So from the ENCOSI community, it's a combination of interacting elements. So we have to identify the system boundary where it's a combination of products, procedures, and people who acts on a specific product. to achieve a specific goals or purpose. And then we'll identify numerous of users and stakeholders which uses this system to achieve these specific goals. And finally, during this systems engineering activity, you will have to describe the first of all the behavioral aspects of your system, how it behaves during time. A second aspect will be what we call the structural aspects, so how it's designed, what are the components, and how they are interconnected together to achieve these specific goals. Then you have also to exhibit the different purposes and goals. And finally, during this systems engineering activity, we will analyze and find new properties or new requirements of your system during this activity. So we'll perform emergence of new properties. So to achieve that, the community has defined some specific standards. And the well-known standard for systems engineering is the ISO 15288, raised in 2015. And we have placed a particular focus on a subset of these processes, the so-called technical processes. And we have just illustrated the main ones, the principle where we place the focus on. You can identify that in these processes you have basically two parts. One focus on the needs, the needs analysis, and it's we called sometimes the problem space. So it's you have two set of processes. The first is called business or mission analysis. And the second one focus on identification of the stakeholder needs and the requirements definition. And in orange part, it's the processes to define the different solution. So it's a technical solution. And we have different processes. The first one called the system requirements definition process. You have the architecture definition, the design definition, and then the system analysis process, who behaves to check and verify if the architecture is suitable for the specific problem. So it's just a kind of a recall. And to perform that, we focus on the traditional engineering consists to analyze stakeholder needs and derive requirements and refine successively the requirements from the what's so-called black box specification down to each components that is included in your architecture. So down to software and hardware components, and divide the requirements for specific subcontractors or specific teams who implements these specific components. Then, if we place the focus on some key activity to achieve these goals, one of them is the architecture definition process and the definition of the interfaces. So a key topic of that is to define an architecture of different connected artifacts, and you have to define the blue context or boundary of your system, what is so-called the system of interest, and then define the external interfaces to specify how the interface behaves with the external environment, and you have also to define the internal interface. So when you use model-based system engineering, generally you have the traditional way of engineering with the requirements. So you see here on the left part, the requirements. So you have the stakeholder needs, the stakeholder requirements, and then the system requirements, generally written in a classical textual form or in specific database. And then you can use the model to achieve and to successively derive your requirements, analyze your findings. And I've placed here three main parts. The first one is called the system operational context, where you identify more the need and the specific scenario of usage. Then you define the system, and then you define the architecture and the specific components. So what the model can help in that process. So here you will see, and we will see successively, that the model here, it's some extraction of Capella model. So we will deep dive into this example during this webinar. And this model can help to formalize the needs successively and perform a kind of zigzag between the requirements definition and analyze the need, and then go back to the requirements and derive, use the model as a support to derive in a step-by-step way the requirements. So this is where the MBSE model can help. And finally, just to illustrate also that MBSE is a good tool to formalize the requirements and to help to ensure the coordination of the system architecture. However, it's a general purpose language, and MBSE is general purpose language. It must be extended or completed with other languages and tools to address specific disciplines. So, for example, when you have multi-physical analysis and simulation, you may need to perform some computation or simulation results in specific languages for that purpose, for Modelica language or Simulink or MATLAB Simulink language. The same for safety analysis and so on. So Capella will help MBSE to coordinate these different disciplines, define their boundaries, and just call the other tools to help in the definition of the specific discipline. So this is what we have as a short introduction as systems engineering. And then we have placed a kind of mapping between this standard processes and the Arcadia methodology. So basically, the Arcadia method is the following. So it's a well-known graph coming from the Capella and Arcadia website. You clearly find the distinction that we have at the beginning between the needs understanding and the solution architectural design. But sometimes, and a lot of our customers have some questions regarding the exact mapping regarding the specific processes from ISO 15288 and these different layers of the Arcadia model. So we try to perform this on our own. So the first process called business or mission analysis may be described using the first Arcadia layer called the operational analysis, where you focus on the overall mission of the system and all the needs. Then I've placed the boundary a little bit, not only on the second layer, so the system analysis layer here. You can map what we call the stakeholder needs and requirements definition, because some stakeholder needs we will see will appear at this operational analysis level, and some others may be extended in the system analysis level. I will explain a little bit later on. Then you have the system requirement definition, which starts as a system analysis layer and may be derived step by step when diving into this Arcadia layer and architecture process. For sure, the main process that is covered here on the logical and physical architecture layers relies to the architecture definition process. And I've placed a little shape here to say that the design definition or the prepare, the transition from the architecture definition to the detailed design may be initiated from the Arcadia and Capella physical architecture layer. But you have also in the ISO 15288 other processes, and I even if it's not the scope, the direct scope of the Arcadia method, you may find some kind of a gateway between the model element that you will find in the Capella model, and can be used as a good support for some processes. For example, regarding the technical management processes, in the technical management processes, you find the different process. And as an illustration to the Capella model may be used as a support for the project assessment and control and measurement. You can measure at any time the progress into the model using the specific metrics and extraction. And you can also assist the review of the model using some specific features of the Capella tool. So this may be addressed in a second way, but you should know that this gateway may exist. And also with other technical processes, in particular for integration and verification and validation aspects, you may find a lot of relevant information into the Capella model to initiate the IVV processes. So this is basically a rough mapping of the processes, and then I propose to illustrate over our Health Agriculture UAVs case study. So I will present our case study. So case study is case study from Samares, initiated by Samares, for training and coaching purpose. So we used it a lot for many customers as a reference project to elicit best practices around the systems engineering. And it has been developed with different languages, with Capella and with other languages, and is illustrated also to illustrate many things such as requirements or other topics. So this case study is quite fictive, hein, because Samares do not sell any UAV, such UAV, but we sell expertise around MBSE. So the case study is concerned a system which will be used to protect the field crops against aggression pathogens. And this system, the mission of the system, consider the usage of an autonomous system to spray product over the field crops autonomously and support the work of a farmer. So I've illustrated the mission here. So the mission is starting from the stakeholders, so the farmer, and we consider that we get topographical data around the map, the field map, and what kind of soil you have around the field and how the shape of the crops are. Then this farmer will build a kind of a treatment plan and will use an autonomous product which will spray the spray product over the field crops. And in the overall mission, we will consider also the fact that the farmer will need at a time to check the effectiveness of the mission and to collect data to see if the product quality, quantity has been enough or too much related to the mission. And we'll consider also influence of the weather conditions to the mission, in particular the wind force that may influence the mission of the system. So why we have used this case study to illustrate, the first interest is because it's highly multi-physical. So it's a cyber-physical system. It's based on the unmanned aircraft vehicle and autonomous. You have a lot of interactions with the farmer or many, many elements. And you have many disciplines, hydraulics, control, propulsion, some various sensors. And another interest of this case study is that we use also, you have different stakeholders, in particular the regulation authorities related to the flight of the drone itself and related to the spraying of the kind of product around the field crops regarding farming regulations. So, what we propose first is to go over, walk through over this, this systems architecture, using, some snapshot, let's say, of the Capella model. So we use first the, what we call the traditional, classical top-down approach, which is recommended in the Arcadia workflow. And we will go through each layer. So first we go to the operational analysis and operational concept. So just the first recall of what is behind. So the focus of the operational analysis is to focus on the stakeholder needs and the overall mission. So the overall mission is what expect the farmer on its interest, what is the mission for, and not really the system of interest scope. You will see that the operational analysis in this example is not focused on any UAV, and this is the specificity of this model. Then we will identify the mission and the involved entities, actors related to this mission. And we will identify also the processes and tasks called operational activities in Capella to achieve the main goals. And then we will use this model to elicit the stakeholder needs and define the overall mission. So let's see what is in the model. So we first go to the operational analysis layer, and we will see that in the operational analysis, there's so several diagrams for sure. And we first start the mission, the goals and purpose definition as operational capability in the Capella model. So you see that here you have the farmer, you have some operational capabilities such as treat field, mission effectiveness analysis. You can see the involved actors like crops and also the weather condition. And we have also attached some properties to the overall capabilities in the model. Then we have defined for each operational capability, we have defined the processes. Processes are here in the bold blue here and represent the kind of initialization of the scenarios used by the mission. And finally, we have built a complete, consistent, overall operational activities to achieve this mission, where you can find in different colors the different processes that are used for this mission. And finally, you see in the complete of operational architecture that you have all the activities allocated to the entities, and as you can see in the model that we proposed here, you have a lot of activities belongs to the farmer entity. As I explained just before, the farmer is the user of the system, and at this stage we are not defining the scope and the boundaries of the system, so we focus on the activities that are required for the farmer actor. So you can see here that in the farmer host a lot of activities like treat the target crops, follow the treatment plan, supervise the mission, and so on. For sure, when you will dive into the system of interest scope, the system will be in charge of some of these activities, and this is what we will see in the next layer. So finally, you will have, as I explained before, for each operational activity, some processes here which describe the flow, interaction flow between actors and between activities to achieve this expected capability. And then we use the operational scenarios to describe what is expected regarding the overall capability. Let's dive into the system boundary now. So the system boundary, so we identified the contribution of the system of interest within the overall mission, and the objective will be to somehow define what is the system will do and what will belong to the different actors of the system. So let's see in the Capella model. So in the Capella model, you see we go in the system analysis. In the system analysis, we will focus now on the mission and capability diagram, where we will focus on the mission and the functionalities ensured by the system itself. So we now dive into the boundary of the system itself. And we define here the mission, the main mission of the OR specific UAV. And we see that new actors have been introduced, such as a regulation actor like EASA for the civil drone standards, and farming regulation have been also considered. Now, you see that you have the full system architecture as a SAB, and you will see that we used also the automated transition to derive from the operational analysis. We have initialized the system functions from the operational analysis layer. Some of them will be completely covered by the system itself, like treat target crops, and some others have been decomposed to introduce the contribution of the system and the contribution of the actor. In the case of supervised mission, the function has been divided in two, and we have introduced the interface between these two functions to ensure the overall activity. And we can see also, finally, that we have introduced at the end a specific actor related to the fact that we have focused now, we have decided that it's a new UAV. And because it's a UAV, you have the regulation of the UAV to consider. And so we have introduced the policeman interaction with the UAV, which is required by the European regulation of civil UAVs. And as you can see, from the operational analysis, we have derived here some function, and we keep the traceability links between the system functions to the operational activities. So it's quite classical. Then we go to the logical architecture, and in the logical architecture, we will decompose the system in subsystems and define their interactions and interface together. So to perform that, let's go directly on the Capella model. You will see that we use the automated transitions to benefit from the functions that are defined from the needs. And then we'll go to the first architecture, let's say, based on the known systems and can be initiated from organizational constraints or from specific patterns or well-known systems. And then the activity now consists to distribute the functions over the subsystems and define now the functional chain to achieve the full end-to-end pass from the external environment to the specific action. So you can see here, you have the red functional chain here represented and the blue one. So where you have each function and its contribution is illustrated and dependency between inputs and outputs have been defined. So basically, so it's the same step. So we distribute and refine the functions down to the logical component of the architecture and maintain the links between the traceability links between the logical architecture functions to the system architecture function. What is a specificity to Capella regarding other MBSC languages is that Capella offers the possibility to completely restructure the functional architecture at the logical architecture level. In some other languages, such as CSML and so on, often the functional architecture is only one architecture. But in Capella, you have the possibility to have a functional architecture initiated from the needs analysis and then let the possibility to the architect to completely restructure the functional architecture due to specificities, to the technical specificities, and then keep the traceability to the origin of the need. And this is clearly one specificity and benefit of the tool regarding other methods. And you have also some golden rules to have in mind, which helps to structure the logical architecture and guide the refinement activity. And to check these rules, the modeling rules have been used, you have a very, very efficient tool in Capella, which is called the Model Validation Tool, which greatly helps to ensure that your model is complete and consistent. And finally, on the classical approach, you have the physical architecture, where we identify the physical components and to implement the conceptual solution. And we demonstrate successively how system requirements have been derived and decomposed over the selected physical components. So in this model, we have just take some snapshots of our model, which is a little bit more larger than this one. So here you can see that we have at high level identify a drone with different subsystems and subcomponents. And if we zoom on the treating system, for example, we have defined different components, so a tank, a pump, some nozzles, some electronic control unit, which commands the spraying of the product over the feed crops. We have also defined in this model the detail of the flight management system and which kind of sensors have been introduced and refined the functions down to the physical architecture level to illustrate and derive all the of the all the specificities. And as usual, we have kept a traceability link to the logical architecture layer and to see how the physical architecture layer implements the logical architecture level. Additionally, we also suggest to clearly build different views for different disciplines, because in physical architecture, you may have numerous of disciplines that are involved. And we propose to clearly use some specific extensions such as PVMT and the diagram styler at least specify the physical nature of each physical link and be able to view clearly on the graph on which kind of nature of interface it is related. For example, in this case, we have decomposed the network and communication interface in green, power supplies in red, and fluid interface in blue. And this allows to view easily different specificities according to each discipline. So it's really a short overview of the model to be able to go on some specific zooms. So as a reminder, so we have developed the operational analysis where you have no system boundary here, just the farmer and lot of activities allocated to the farmer. Derive to the system analysis, we still on the need, then go to the solution successively in logical architecture and then on physical architecture with different models. Here is propulsion, flight management system, and treatment system. So this is quite not new. It's N plus one examples in Capella. What is quite new in this presentation is a focus on some specific systems engineering practice and how to implement it. So we have placed three focus here in this presentation. One is called MOEs and MOPs. So the first topic is, so it's just a reference to some INCOSI material. So the INCOSI defines that in your model, in your project, you should define on the overall mission, what they call the measure of effectiveness, so MOEs, to specify which kind of performance may be, if this criteria is not filled, it could be a failure of the overall mission. And then it's derived in the different V-cycle to different topics. And one other important element is the MOP called measure of performance. And what is the performance expected from the system point of view to achieve the intended functionality? So to perform that, we propose to use different techniques. So it can be a mix, but this is a very efficient way to illustrate. So you can attach some specific property values to some elements. So in particular, in the operational analysis layer, we clearly recommend to use MOE as a package of property values attached to the operational capabilities, which reflect to the overall mission expectations. And then create also some specific properties on the mission and capabilities level in the system analysis layer to describe the expected performances. And you can use in Capella an object called generic trace, which allows to describe the traceability between the MOP to the MOE and to keep safe the traceability scheme, let's say. So this is a first step, which is, in my knowledge, not really explained in the Arcadia method today. So it's just a recommendation or a suggestion on our side to illustrate the MOEs and MOPs. The second topic I would like to discuss is we have a lot of customers who struggle with a specificity that, okay, Arcadia is a top-down approach, but we have a lot of existing systems which are not modeled, and we would like to create a kind of snapshot of what we have and check how our existing system can fit to the new need of the customer. And the way is described, the traditional way is described, the Arcadia method is more a top-down. You coming from a new need, and then you describe a specific system. So the traditional approach, the classical top-down approach, refers to you get a customer needs, a statement of work, and then you execute in a sequence operational analysis, system analysis, logical architecture, and physical architecture down to this scheme and go down to the defined technical solution. But it's not fitting to the existing situation in many, many companies. So what we recommend on our side is to use what we call a meet in the middle approach, where you can execute in parallel the physical architecture of the system by describing your existing systems. And in parallel, you can create the operational analysis and system analysis related to the need. And at the end, you can find a kind of compromise or mapping in the logical analysis layer, where you can describe the traceability information from the physical architecture to the system analysis layer. And this can be illustrated there in this model of the HAUAV model, where you have this logical architecture, where you find realization links from the system analysis layer to the logical architecture layer. And then from the physical, you can check and ensure that this logical architecture fits the need described in the system analysis layer. So this is clearly a recommendation on our side, which helps greatly to ensure a kind of compromise between what is existing and how can I fit the need from the customer. And finally, the last topic that is also a very, very common topic of our customers is how to manage the multi-levels and sharing responsibility between teams. And in particular, when you have a very, very complex systems, you have an overall system architect, which is in charge of the overall system, and he delegates the architecture of subsystems to another one, which is belongs to the same company or to another company. And then we have to move the system of interest scope. So it defines the requirements to the overall system and then allocate requirements to this architect, which will use it to describe its own architecture. And to perform this, clearly what can be done is to use the system to subsystem add-on from Capella, where here I've illustrated our UAV. At the beginning, we perform a Capella model at this level, and we perform a full logical architecture containing all the systems, propulsion system, tweeting system, and so on. And then you can move the system of interest by using the automation. And then it moves the system of interest scope, transform all the surrounding systems to actors, and then limit the scope of only what is inside the UAV or the drone. And this is clearly a good help to achieve the distribution of requirements and responsibility when you have very, very, very complex systems. Yeah. And this might be illustrated in this video. So where we focused on a specific system, I think it's a flight management system. So we will focus, put our attention. So we have developed the overall model, and we want to now derive the flight management system as a subsystem. So you can now use the system to subsystem transition with vertical SA option, and it will create a new Capella model called flight management system, where the scope, the system of interest scope, has been moved to a lower level. And now the system analysis has been populated with all surrounding systems as actors, and the functional scope of the flight management system have been reduced, and the functions have been allocated to this system. And then the new architect may, as is its playground, to now describe the internal functions inside this system. And at each step, you have, so what is explained in the video, maybe it's a little bit fast, but that when you have a change from the overall model, and then it can be merged within the children project, the flight management system project, and then it keeps safe the consistency with the new features introduced within the within the main project in the sub project. So now I will arrive to the conclusion. So as a synthesis, so MBSC and Capella offers, let's say, a lot of facility to master the complexity of the system and to refine the needs from the customer, and to find a good solution with keeping safe the traceability and the different complexity levels. But you should keep in mind that the tool is a tool, but the key of success is a good combination between the processes and the tools. So it's generally three aspects, process, method, and tools. And this is a good combination to achieve a success. A tool without process, even if it's Arcadia driven, is not enough. You should clearly integrate the Arcadia method in your process, requirements management, configuration management process, and so on, to be efficient. Now we also have used this health agriculture UAV for many, many, many purposes. For your information, we use it for as a basics for our internal case training. So we are at Samares, a training center, and we provide training and support on MBSE and systems engineering in general, and on MBSE, particularly in Capella, Arcadia. We provide training with this specific case study. We have also developed this case study for complementary topics such as requirements analysis, simulation, co-simulation, product line engineering, and we use it quite daily, let's say, as a reference project for our customers. And I would say this: what is in orange below, that methods and best practices are often common to many, many industries, even if each customer has, it's my own process or so on. And really, to use the Health Agriculture UAV today, we use it as a reference project and non-confidential. It can be used. And it's really a good practice to share the best practice within the community. As a teasing, we consider in the future months to provide our HA UAV case study as open source and to share with the Capella community. So, and we use it also as a reference today for various customer support in different industries, so energy, military and defense, oil and gas, many, many, many topics. And that's all. So now I would say that I've finished my presentation. If you have any question, you'd be very welcome.
Okay, thank you, Sébastien. I'll just move the slides. Okay, I'll let you share your screen if needed. We have a number of questions in the Q&A, so let's go over them. We sort them by priority. So the first question we have is, you are showing okay, here's the question, you should see it. You're showing software hardware requirements, but what about human requirements?
I would say that basically we could attach these requirements to, so it's also not completely presented in this presentation, but I would say that these human requirements may be detailed using these actors and the humans involved in this. We, with some customers, we have also considered, but it's a specific activity that we perform with some customers, human factors and how the roles may be shared between specific entities. So this may be, this should be maybe a topic for a next presentation to go in details.
Okay, thank you. So the next question, I believe you've already answered, but I just show it for you to confirm that you have answered.
Yes, we will share this in the few months. Yeah, sure.
Okay, great. So then the next question is about safety analysis. Can you do it directly in Capella or are you using add-ons?
I would say that in Capella, some elements, so it's more on the systems engineering side. We have been involved as Samares in some safety and systems engineering collaboration topic. I would say generally we rely for the safety analysis to external tools and efficient gateway between the tools with the appropriate method.
Okay.
You have several ones. Some of them have been presented, I think, in previous webinars. But we also considering, for example, for this safety analysis, usage of MBSE, so model-based safety assessment tools, from the for example, Altarica community.
Okay. Thank you. And now, very specific questions about the elicitation of stakeholder needs.
I would say that it would be difficult to address in detail this topic now, but I would say that the model can help to identify missing elements or something which is quite vague in the initial statement of work, and we'll use the model to elicit the requirement, maybe also combine efficiently some requirements tools that are used to elicit some requirements in combination with Capella.
Okay. And then there are really many questions and so little time, so I'm trying to choose as I go while you answer. So how do you define, derive, and decompose the user needs, the functions, and the elements, and allocate them to each other concurrently? That's the point of Arcadia, I would say.
Yeah, I would say that it's basically the point of Arcadia. We have go very, very short, quick on this topic due to the webinar duration. I would say that basically in Arcadia, you have automated transition, and with the Capella tool, you have automated transition that greatly helps to keep the traceability from each layer to another layer. And then, even if you completely restructure the functional architecture, you may maintain the traceability coverage to the initial link needs using the traceability links in the tool.
Okay, and for more on all that, I believe there are many other webinars, including here, about Arcadia that go more in detail. Okay, another question is about system to subsystem transition and how it relates to ISO 15288.
So in the system to subsystem, it's when you... The system to subsystem transition works in the following way. It's a top to down. So when you derive a system, a subsystem from a system, you introduce functions into the subsystem or some elements into the subsystem. And if a new one has been included in the system project, you have the EMF diff and merge tool, which opens and then propose you to evaluate how to merge these different features. However, the opposite direction is not covered as far as I know, from the subsystem to the overall system.
Okay, I believe we don't have more time to elaborate on that. There is another related question. I think there's a lot of interest on the relation with ISO 15288. This is from Jean-Luc.
System requirement. The system requirements are so you have in the ISO 15288, as far as I know, you collect the overall system requirements. So then at the system analysis level, you have the high level requirements, let's say. And then I would just explain that when you go down to the functional and to the logical and physical architecture, you may derive new requirements going to the low level requirements, and the physical solution may introduce new requirements over the full life cycle.
Okay. I believe we are out of time. There are a few questions, but I believe they mostly were covered by previous questions. I'm just checking. Or just a few more questions then, and let's go.
And if you have a very detailed question, don't hesitate to contact us, and we...
And you'll be open for discussion.
Performance dynamic behavior of the UAV. Yeah, I've not entered into this detail because it's not the scope of this presentation. But we can also, in the near future, to explain how to use the modes and states machine efficiently to give more details about how we elaborate the dynamic behavior.
Okay, and a last one. Is there a way in Arcadia and Capella to specify a technical performance measure?
It's not expressed in my sense, but TPM, yes, for sure. We can do also same way by adding some properties and parameters to each physical component. So this could be elaborated further. I don't see any issue on that. But it has not been elaborated in this simple example, let's say.
Okay, thank you very much, Sébastien. I thank you for your attention and goodbye.